Greetings, fellow Earthlings. Welcome back to Delta Force 2. We are continuing with Operation Global Enforcement. Now, we have four missions to choose from, and this is like the hidden bonus mission. It doesn't really affect the plot of the game as much. But the rest of the three missions are important to the plot. And going through the summaries of all three missions, High Command, that is me, has decided that Mission Control is probably the most important because it deals with hostages. So United Freedom has secured a missile launch facility and taken the facility's personnel captive. Secure the hostages and lead them to safety. And that is pretty much the mission briefing, to be honest. That is the summary. Let's go ahead and listen to the briefing.
DIA has informed us of a critical situation. United Freedom has not only managed to hold on to some weapons-grade material, they've succeeded in creating a warhead and secured a launch facility for a makeshift missile. We can't make a direct assault without first obtaining intel on the layout of the facility. Proceed to the objective and rescue the launch personnel. Your insertion point will be 400 meters west of the objective. Once you secure the hostages, all teams will make their way west to the extraction point. All UF forces encountered must be eliminated quickly and quietly to avoid jeopardizing the safety of the hostages. They are the key to the layout of the facility. Once we know the layout, be prepared to move immediately to the launch site for the final assault.
Okay, now the weapons recommended to us are the MP5 SD. Now this, I think, would be useful for this situation since stealth is important, and since we're getting ghillie suit as well, I'll try playing with this loadout in and of itself. Although I'm pretty sure that I can actually go ahead and take the grenade launcher as well. I think I can do this because the enemies do not apparently respond to sound. As long as we're crawling on the ground, they will not be able to hear us. So let's try this.
King 6, Charlie 1. We've got a lot of movement. Looks like one and two man patrols.
Bravo, King 6. Avoid contact with the patrols. We don't want them panicking and killing hostages.
Yeah, so there's an element of speed to this mission, speed and expediency. Especially once you're compromised, you need to be quick. And you essentially need to execute it very quickly. Your maneuvers so that the hostages remain safe and secure. And I do believe that if I have difficulty using this weapon, I might as well return to simply using the weapon that I have been meaning to use, the silenced weapon, even though it does not have a scope and it sucks. Good thing is, it's silent, so enemies will never be alert. And right now what I'm going for is just to get a good vantage point right here from on top of that overlook. And we have an enemy right here that we should shoot.
This is Charlie 1, we're compromised! Move in, move in!
That guy's dead. And so will this guy be. There are more folks there. And did that guy die, or did he just decide to fake his own death? I cannot tell, to be honest. There should also be some folks on top of this mountain here. Taken out. There are also folks down here. Okay, do not kill Charlie. I'm warning you. You kill Charlie and you're dead. Probably should zero into a better range. It's strange. I tried shooting out the BRDM the previous time around. It did not work out. The BRDM would not die. And the thing is, I don't exactly want to use the Uh, What do you call it? Forgot the proper term for it. Yeah, sorry, I forgot what I was trying to say. I sort of got busy clearing the folks out from over there. But yeah, what I was saying is I don't exactly want to use the grenade launcher as much either. That sort of makes things difficult for us. There you are. Just wondering where you are. Somebody should be right here. There you are. Stay there. Don't make me come all the way down just to get you. You made me come all the way down just to get you, didn't you? Now I'm trying to be cautious here and not fall. But that isn't always how things work. Sometimes the enemy wants to make you fall off the edge. I guess we'll deal with you later. Come on. Time is of the expediency right now. Time is of import right now because the enemies, they can... Like, once you're discovered, you only have like a limited amount of time before they execute the hostages. So time is of the importance. The importance of time is of importance. Time is of importance, yeah. Sometimes I just forget my English. Pardon me, words is not my first language, even though I do believe I'm more fluent in English than my own native tongue. But, just the effects of globalism. No enemies here, even though there was supposed to be one. But hey, I checked. That is all I really wanted to do. Just check to see if there were any enemies there. And there are definitely going to be enemies up ahead. And we need to take them out as expediently as possible. No delays cannot be tolerated. Will not be tolerated. Any enemies up there? Should be a few, but I can't see any. Charlie team is waiting on the very corner, very edge of the map. Wonder why they haven't started their incursion yet. Maybe because I haven't started my incursion yet? I mean, it seems to be the only explanation, to be honest. Yes, we're hoping that I do not get shot.
Bravo, the hostages are in the larger building.
Roger, King 6. Can I not shoot you? Thank you, it's like using the scope makes all the difference in the world. Now again, expediency is key. We need to be quick. Is Charlie 2 dead? I hope not. I did not get notified of that development. But there are folks in these here buildings and, well, all I'll say is we need to be cautious. Or pay the price. There are multiple hostages in there, and the best we can do is just pray that it ends well. I'm just checking out if there's checking for other enemies there. Can't see any, but I do recall one of them. That hopefully took care of somebody, some of the enemies, but of course I cannot be sure. Pretty sure there are like enemies in there as well. I'm just trying to hurry here to make sure that these guys are still alive when I go get them. There you are. Reloading. There's another guy in there. Expected another guy to be in there actually.
Oh my
god. Now this is where we want to be cautious. Somebody saw us.
Bravo, King 6. Sweep the area and clear out the remaining terrorists.
I think we could have used the back entrance here to come in as well. We're just prone, being prone here so that it's difficult for the terrorists to see us. And given how dark it is inside that room, I wonder how those hostages can actually be there. So basically, we just need to... That's nice.
King 6, Charlie 1.
That's it?
The area is secure. The hostages are safe. I say again, the hostages are safe.
Roger, King 6.
Roger, Charlie. Black Widow is inbound.
Cool, so that was all this mission was about. I thought we were supposed to pick these hostages up and then assault some of the base or something. Or I suppose that's like the sequel mission. Maybe I should have played this later. Let's see. Let's listen to the briefing of the sequel mission and make a decision on that. I'll just end this mission here. This has actually unlocked, completing mission control has unlocked Scorched Earth, which is essentially the final mission of this campaign. But we also have mission Knockout and mission Steel Coffin remaining, so we also need to complete those two missions. And this mission I'll be completing after the finale. It's more like a tie-up sort of mission, tying up loose ends in the same fashion that the Splinter Cell games go. You take out the baddie, big bad first, and then then there's some or the other minor trivial things remaining to accomplish, like something to clean up after the bad guy has done shitting all over the place. So yeah, as far as this mission was concerned, mission control, this is it. Thank you for watching, thank you for tuning in, and thank you for sticking around until the end. I sort of messed up the sequence there, but doesn't matter. When we come back, we will be covering either Knockout or Steel Coffin, and we'll take a decision based on what we're feeling like at the moment. But for now, I'm going to shelf Scorched Earth, and we will pretend that it never happened. Maybe I'll release Mission Control at a later time as well. And yeah, we'll be covering Four Horsemen at the very end. Now, yeah, let's see what we'll be covering out of Mission Knockout or Mission Steel Coffin. Or maybe if I release Mission Control later after those missions, then maybe we'll be covering Scorched Earth after this. So, depends on when I decide to release this for you guys. Anyhow, I think I'll release this after I complete Knockout and Steel Coffin. So yeah, the next time we come back, we'll cover Mission Scorched Earth. We've already covered Mission Knockout and Steel Coffin by this time. So, yeah. See you then. Take care.